Dear learners, this class lecture is for BCCA 7-1 students for financial accounting. I am Assistant Professor Kailesh Muralidhar Jaitwal. Welcomes you all in this lecture on behalf of GS College of Commerce, Wardha. In previous lecture, we have seen that what is the accounting, what do you mean by account, and what are its concept and its introductory and historical part. In this lecture, we will going to see what is the accounting conventions and what is GAAP. Okay, so let's see how we can go through with accounting conventions. As you can see on blackboard, we have four conventions. Okay, first we will start with materiality. First convention is materiality. What materiality tells us? Materiality, as its name showing that materiality means the important, significant, and too much essential thing, right? That means it is material. The concept of materiality says record material essential details and ignore insignificant one. That means you have to consider only and only significant details. Unnecessary details should not be considered in financial accounts, financial statements. Okay, let's have an example of necessary and unnecessary things. Let's say we have business of 5 crore. Okay, we have business of 5 crore. We lost goods of rupees 500. We have business of 5 crore and we have lost goods of rupees 500. In proportion to the business turnover, this is two minute thing which can be considered as insignificant, that cannot be showed in footnote or in financial statement, that can be ignored or that can be considered as normal loss, right? Let's see the another example. We have business of 5,000, right? Business of rupees 5,000 and we lost the goods for 500. Then you will see that we have lost our 10% of goods. Here if you will find that, you will see that there is 0.1% loss here, 0.01% loss here, 10%. Then a business should consider this one. This is huge loss and this is not. So this is how you can segregate the things and how you can say what is necessary and what is not necessary for you. You understood this example? Okay. Come to the second concept. The concept of consistency. What do you, in general way, what do you mean by consistency? Consistency means the way you are providing anything or anything you can take, that should be done at regular basis. Regular means there should be the consistent way. There should not be the patches. There should not be some obstacles in your thing, right? You should be more consistent. This principle says you should be too much consistent. Okay. This concept says same accounting principle should be followed year on year. Why you should be following same principle each and every year? Example, if you are providing depreciation on particular asset, if you have chosen in 2017 that we should provide depreciation on the machinery at FIFO method, that means first in first out method. Here you will not change the you will not change suddenly the method of depreciation. You will not suddenly shift to the another method, let's say the LIFO method, that means last in first out method, or depreciation sinking fund method. You cannot shift to the another method. You should have to be you have to be strict to particular method. Okay, but this does not mean that you will not able to change anything. You can change, but you have to make note and have to present your changes between after the financial statement, that is in footnote of financial statement. Okay, these changes can be changes whenever it is needed, and but the thing is that should be informed to shareholders, the investors, the creditors, the bankers, and all. And if you want an example of consistency, if you have, let's say, some disease, chronic disease, and doctor has provided you the medication and said you should be taking this medicine each and every day, that means doctor is appealing you for consistency in your medication. That is the example of consistency. Okay, let's see the third convention. What third convention says? Third convention says conservation. Our third convention is concept of conservation. What the meaning of conservation is? Conservation means playing very safe. That means you should be proactive towards your activities. That means if there is any chance of losses, you should record that loss right now. This game is called as playing safe game. Why? Because what the concept of conservation says, you should record prospective losses in your accounting statements, but you cannot record prospective incomes. What I said, you should record prospective expenses and you should not record prospective incomes. This is law, and because of this, business become a safe game. If you are recording income as well, the future incomes, and you don't know that will be gained or not, but you are recording, and if will not be earning, if you will not able to earn that income, then that can impact you on your financial statements. Hence, conservation says you should record prospective losses and not prospective incomes. You should record prospective expenses but not prospective incomes. Let's say example in this for this concept. In this concept, let's say example of a neighbor. A neighbor has taken rupees 10,000 from you. And he was saying ki, please provide me 10,000, I will be giving you back in next 1 month. He was your neighbor and you provided 10,000, you owe the amount, and after owing that, you got some information that he hasn't paid a rent to the landlord for 5 months. He is not generating any income from since 7 to 8 months. What you will do? You will think my 10,000 might be converted into a 10,000 loss. In this case, what you will do? you will pass an entry that you know that that person will not be able to give. We generally we can ask money, we can ask for returning money, but if he is not providing you money, then what you will do? You cannot do anything. You have to make you have to register that loss in your financial statement. Okay, so you have to record that loss not in future but in present. This game is called conservation. Understood? In this concept, because of this concept, we provide provisions. Provisions means the thing which you provide in present for future. If you have purchased, if you have sold goods to some other person and he will not be able to return amount, you know that he will not be able to amount, he will not be able to provide you your whole amount, then you will make a entry named as bad debts or reserve for doubtful debts. This concept comes under the concept of conservation. Provision for bad debts, provision for taxes, provision for any loss. This all types of provision we made because of this conservation concept. Right? The last accounting convention is concept of disclosure. That means you have to disclose all your necessary thing, all fair and material things which is actually needed by financial statements. You have to be too much stick to the concept of materiality, consistency and conservation in this concept. In this concept, you will find that 1, 2, 3 will implies in this particular concept. Okay, conservation 1, materiality, and conservation 2, consistency, 3, conservation. These should be recorded and fairly provided to externals and as well as internals in your financial statement properly. You have to disclose properly. Each and every important thing you have to disclose in financial statements. Right. Let's see what we have seen yet. We have seen materiality, where we record only material and essential things. We know what consistency is. Consistency means following same rules, principles year on year. That can be changed, but only if needed. Concept of conservation. Conservation provides us various provisions. What conservation says, record prospective losses but not income. What disclosure says, disclose all fair and material things, which implies in 1, 2, 3 conventions. 1, 2, 3 conventions, right? Be with me, focus on study, right? Don't take it as granted, right? Please study. We are moving to the next concept. Let's say what the next concept is. Okay. All okay so far? Can we start the other topic? Okay. So first we have seen accounting convention. The second one we will be going to study is GAAP. GAAP, GAAP. What it stands for? GAAP stands for Generally Accepted Accounting Principles. Just focus on the concept, what it stands for. Generally Accepted Accounting Principles. Generally means we not recording or following this concept in occasional manner. We are following this concept in regular manner. That means generally. Generally accepted.
What gap contains? What do you mean by gap? So gap is generally, the gap is generally contains accounting concepts and accounting conventions. In previous lecture we have seen what is accounting concept, right? Accounting concepts and what is accounting convention, which we have seen here. Gap contains all of this. Okay? So what if you want to define gap in a line, what we can say in line for gap is, it is a commonly set of rules. What it will contain? Rules that companies must follow when preparing financial statements. Let's see it again. What it is? It is a set of rules and regulations followed by particular company in general manner for preparing financial statements. Right? This is all about GAAP, generally accepted accounting principles. We have seen GAAP. We are moving to the next topic. That one is US GAAP. What is US GAAP? As we know what US means, United States. GAAP means generally accepted accounting principles, right? US GAAP, United States generally accepted accounting principles. It is followed by USA. It had established in 1973, and it is taken into consideration from 1973, and it is given by a particular committee. So who bought this? This is bought by Financial Accounting Standard Board, FASB. It is generally known as FASB. Financial Accounting Standard Board. Okay? Let's see what are its objectives. But before that, I want to tell you that we have done with these concepts. Okay? And US has its own GAAP. And by the way, what India is following now, it is followed by US only. And what we follow, what India follows, is IFRS. It is followed by India. IFRS is followed by India, and US GAAP is followed by US. And IFRS is followed by 120 countries, and US GAAP is followed by only USA. So please take it into consideration that GAAP is for US, GAAP is for USA, and for us GAAP is IFRS. So let's see what its objectives are. Its objectives, I have mentioned the main five objectives. First one is to provide reliable and relevant financial statements. If we are mentioning these conventions, because of this convention, our financial statements become too much reliable, too much material, and too much informative, right? Hence, this becomes the primary objective of GAAP. Let's see the second objective. Second objective is to provide comparability by consistency. Here we have seen that accounting conventions provide consistency. GAAP means concept and conventions. That means conventions. GAAP is nothing but concept and conventions. and because of these conventions, our financial instruments become comparable, and because of consistency, this can be compared very easily. Third point is to make accounting process more uniform. Here we have seen that consistency should be in your financial statement, in your financial statement making procedure, and these conventions make this objective successful. That means our accounting process, there should be a consistency. Because of gap, our financial statement is easily comparable. Fourth one is to assist organization in for regarding economic resources. Because of accounting concepts, we account all our financial statements properly. That means you are handling your resources, your financial resources, very properly and in a proper manner. Hence, this makes that economic resources can be easily managed because of these statements. And the last objective of GAAP is to present and measure financial statements. The last objective is making financial statement more reliable, comparable, uniform, and measurable. This is all about the objectives of GAAP. This is for the tomorrow's lecture. In next lecture, we will be studying the conceptual basis of balance sheet and what is capital and revenue, income and expenditure, and accounting, Indian accounting standard. This is a reminder for you. You will be getting your assignments after Diwali, and we will be taking your quiz online to check your knowledge. So please watch videos fully and please study, and be safe in your home, and happy Diwali.